Right, hi, it's James Hardiman here from heyjameshowdoi.com, and what we're about to do is doing the wiring up and connecting of the heater block and the thermistor into the Mendel Parks version 9 hot end. And here's what you need. You need your hot end. You definitely need the heater block. And one of the first things you need to do is just check whether it goes neatly through this hole, and mine does. But sometimes you will find that this heater block is a funny shape. I did one the other day that was just a bit curved and it would not go into that hole. And then what I needed was an 8mm drill and, not an 8mm drill, a 5.5mm drill. What am I talking about? 5.5mm drill to drill that hole out. Just to show, my is actually measures at 4.84mm and it does fit in this hole. And what I did was just kind of in the electric drill woggle it around and up and down and keep doing it until my resistor fitted in there nice and neatly. But I don't need to do that today, so I'll put all those drills away. What else will you need? Well, when you come to do the thermistor, the thermistor is actually 1.5mm across, and this hole is 1.5mm hole, but sometimes it's just not big enough, so you might need a 1.5mm drill to drill that hole out. You need some skinny caps on tape. You're going to need two different sizes of ferrules, which should come in your pack. You need the thermistor, which is this little tiny job. You need the cables to cable it up with and something to strip the ends. Some heat shrink tubing. Just going to put my 1.5mm drill back in the box before it gets lost. Some silicone sealant. And you're probably going to need some sharp knives and scissors to cut the caps and tape. And it can get to be quite a fiddly job, so I've got some tweezers. And I've also got one of these devices which clips onto my table, and these little crocodile clips, it's coming undone, hold things neat and tidy. So when we get to that part, you'll see me using this. This part is a magnifying glass just in case, and the reason that the magnifying glass has a little hat on is because I'm working in a south-facing conservatory, and believe it or not, the sun can shine brightly enough through this to set fire to things. So just keep that out of the way for the moment. Okay, so I already know that my heater resistor is going to fit in there very nicely, so that's fine. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut open a little container, a little packet. These are really rubbish scissors. I must get some better scissors. Take out the thermistor. And the thermistor is minute. And the business end is this little tiny glass bead. And one of the jobs we're going to have to do is that these wires coming off of the thermistor need to be insulated and wrapped. They're not insulated, so they need to be kept apart. But the first thing I want to do is to see whether it's going to fit in that hole. And the answer is no, not really. So the first thing I'm going to do is drill that hole out with my 1.5mm drill. So not a big deal. I can do it by holding everything by hand. And that's probably enough. Let's just check. Yep. Drops in nicely now. Okay, so what we're now going to do is insulate the legs of the thermistor before we do anything else. So I'm just going to get that set up. Okay, so I've got this set up in my my little device here with the crocodile clips, and I'm going to be slightly embarrassed doing this because it's a job that has to be done reasonably neatly and tidily. And I'm a bit of a klutz with these things, but you'll get the idea. So I'm using this narrow Kapton tape. Come on, Kapton tape. And the first thing I want to do is just take a little narrow piece and put it between the wires up as tight close as I can to the thermistor, and just do that. Yeah, that's fine. I'll trim all the rest off in a moment. And I'm going to do another piece the other side. I'm sure there are neater ways of doing this, but this is the umpteenth that I've done this way and it works for me. So if you've got a neater way, that's fine. So having done that, I'm going to trim these pieces off in a moment. I'm going to take them down, put them on the bench and trim them with a knife. But I'm also just going to go a little bit further south with the Kapton tape on both sides. And this time I'm going to try and, just fold it around this way. Done. And fold this one around. This way. Oh, it's all squeezing up. There we go. So that's done good enough. Now I'm going to put it down on the bench and trim it off with a knife. So there it is with the Kapton tape trimmed up reasonably nicely. Be very careful when you're trimming with a knife that you don't cut the wires. And I've got a couple of pieces of heat shrink tubing which I'm going to put over in a minute to protect it even better. So here I am just slipping on this very small piece of high temperature heat shrink tubing, one on each leg. You get a piece of this with your Mendel parts kit, but actually I love this stuff. It does make things so much neater, so I've got quite a lot of my own. And I've snugged those right up to the end of the thermistor there. And now with my paint stripper hot air gun, I'm just going to warm up the heat shrink tubing until it shrinks.
Fine.
And I'm now ready to glue both of these in place using the silicone sealant, which is quite messy stuff. And I'm going to start off with just a little dab. So I've cleaned up the silicone sealant tube and here comes the sealant and just a little splot in that hole there. And put some all around. So in the end I had to take the cap off and now I've got rather more than I need on the resistor. But it doesn't really matter because it's reasonably easy to clean up. So I'm just going to twist this in here and make sure that's in there reasonably nicely. Check the other side. Yeah, I could do with some on the other side, so I'm just going to use my knife blade to take some from this side and smear it all around on that side. It's all a bit of a mess, but actually once it's dry it's pretty easy to clean up, as you will see later on. I'll just clean that off now. Clean off enough so that I don't get it all over my fingers. And just pop in the thermistor. Come on, get in. That's it, and now I'm going to leave it for about an hour and a half. It's quite cool in this conservatory, but even so, it should be hard within an hour and a half. I'm going to clean up my knife blade and then just leave it, and we'll come back and finish off then. While that's drying, I just thought I would prepare the cables, and the first thing I've done is I've just taken a very short piece of high temperature heat shrink fat stuff and put on there. Just to hold this end of the wiring loom nice and steady. And now I'm going to strip the ends of these wires, and I'm not going to bother to video that because I'm sure you don't need me to show you how to do that. So that's that done. Stripped back and twisted. I'm probably being a little bit too generous, but that's fine. I can always trim it off later. And the next thing we're going to do is to identify which wire is which. And to do that, what you're going to need is your Gen 6 board. So here's your Gen 6 board, and this is the plug where the heater and the thermistor Molex plugs in. But you need to look here, and I'm hoping I can keep this in focus. When you get down there, yep, it says heaters 1 and 2 NTC, which means thermistor, 3 and 4 heat. So the next question is, over here, which pin is 1 and which pin is 4? And if you look here, very carefully, right in the corner of that mounting square, you can see the number 1. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4 from our right to our left. So if we plug the plug in, we can see that brown and black is 1 and 2. And if we come over here, we can see that 1 and 2, brown and black, is the thermistor. And yellow and grey is 3 and 4. And if we come over here, we can see that 3 and 4 are the heater. You can now unplug it and put your Gen 6 board away back in its little silvery bag until you're ready to install it. I even made a note. Brown and black, thermistor, yellow and grey, heater.